Yeah, Jazz won! Woo! Yeah! Woo! Yeah, woo! Let's go, Nick!
You get half of them.
It's my child.
Get them up there on first. That's crazy.
I had to do the hard part.
Yeah, right.
My child.
Freshman on first trumpet, right? That's my brother. Let's go. This is about to be epic. Why are you already recording? What are you doing?
I wanted to get the whole front part of it.
You have a minute already that nobody's gonna watch.
Yeah, they will. Valin will watch it.
Give a shout out to Valin.
The whole. Okay. Shout out Valin because you're epic.
And you're my child.
Cut everything up into that point.
No.
Please.
I wanted to get the whole intro.
Whatever.
Quick zoom in on Valin for our audience.
That's Jack. That's Valin. There you go.
That would be him right there.
Thank you. On the stage. Our booster club bought that for us, so super cool. Will Farley, extremely talented musician, using it as a chair. You need a chair? I also want to thank our school district, our principal, Dr. Kimberly Jensen is here tonight, and thank you for all of your support. First year here at Big High School, just joined and doing an awesome job supporting every program, and this isn't an easy job. We have, I think, all of our fall sports teams made it to state, just about all of our winter programs made it to state. We've made it to state with individuals and groups. And spring sports is just getting started, so there's lots more to come. But anyway, it's just a really busy, busy job, and so I appreciate all of your efforts and time that you put in. You know, it's not an easy gig, so thank you to our new principal. Quickly, want to also recognize we're at the University of Montana, and I was sharing with the students today, it's just such an important thing for us to do to get out and attend university festivals for networking purposes, for sharing our music. And a lot of these guys, I'm gonna kind of put them on the spot. I don't know the answers to this question from all of them, but I know that it's significant from some of them. Part of the reason that we do that too is so that they're kind of marketing themselves. And so students, just really quickly, how many of you guys have already received some scholarship awards, letters, or notifications from other universities like Whitworth or Montana and some of those? You already know how much money you're getting. Raise your hand high, proud.
Will.
Yeah. And I think it's early in the year, and there's gonna be more to come, so those of you guys that aren't sure about music and whether or not it might pay off someday, or I'm not gonna do that forever, you don't have to major in it. A lot of these guys are gonna get scholarships in other subjects or in music, but they're not necessarily majoring in music, so it's a big deal. The other cool little side piece of information on this, or that's a cool story, we had one of our saxophone players, he was right here in the alto saxophone section, here leading the saxophone section. One of the reasons we like to get out and perform our music is because we are entertaining people, hopefully reaching people, whether that's through excitement or other emotions that might be involved. But everybody knows who J.K. Simmons is, maybe? The actor that played in Whiplash. I promise I'm not like him. I'm a good teacher if you would watch the movie. His parents were teachers at the University of Montana. And they started a solo award, started sponsoring one, and their niece that was in attendance at the festival, and was just captured by Keith's work soloing. She received this outstanding soloist award. And so she shared those with J.K. Simmons, and so it's just kind of cool to connect with bigger circles of people that way. And so, Keith, congratulations on that. That's super cool. So I don't want to forget anybody's names, but just some recognition that we had from the University of Montana Festival. From Jazz to Ivy on drum set, and Ivy's still here down here. Great job, Ivy. And Billy Stadenhouse, thank you very much. Yeah, the guest band. Such a beautiful sound. From Jazz 1, Hannah Robbins was recognized for just that beautiful flute work that she did in that last tune. It's just so cool. Our entire rhythm section was selected as the outstanding rhythm section. That's Will Farley on guitar, Valin Gabriel and Colin McKenna that shared piano duties, Jake Gendreau on bass, and Catherine Selby on drum set. And really have to give it up. I know I need to get on. I know it's like the award ceremony when you start playing music and get gone out or whatever, but I have to recognize Catherine too, because she's brand new at drum set at this level in Jazz 1. She's only a sophomore and came in just really green, but she stayed with it and really worked hard. And you probably would know tonight that she's really just getting started on drum set, which is cool for all of us to know where she's going to be in the next couple of years. It's just really cool to see her development over the years. So, bravo, Catherine. Really good. Also, three people were selected as the only three outstanding soloists of the day on Friday while we were there. And you heard from trombone player Will Stroud. He's one of them. Tegan Bright, I mentioned just a second ago on alto sax. And then a very, very talented, special young man on tenor saxophone, Nicholas Carr, was also selected. And we're going to feature him next on a beautiful ballad. It's got a little bit more of a modern twist to it. This is called Anxiously Awaiting by Ben Patterson, and it's going to feature a senior, Nick Carr, on tenor sax.
Thank you.
weekend for Four Point this week, by the way?
I hope so, if he comes.
Four Point.
All
right.
Yeah, Valin!
Nice. He's a 4.0.
Yeah,
all right, this last two is a lot of fun. This one's entitled Certified, and it's a blues progression, but it's 16 bars, because it's got this four-bar insert in the middle of it, so it changes up the feel of it a little bit. So if you find yourself grooving along like this is the blues, you go, wait, where are we? Oh, there we are. Because most of us have heard of blues, and you can kind of tell how that feels and cycles. This one might throw you in for a little bit. It's going to feature, let's see, we've got Will Farley right here on guitar. We'll hear from Will Straub again on trombone. We'll hear from Nick Carr again on tenor saxophone. We'll hear from Tegan Bright on alto saxophone. And just a lot of great work over here in the rhythm section, whether it's Colin or Valin, Jake Gendro, just laying it down on the bass. And our clinician last week, his name is Greg Thomas, just a super fantastic musician. But he was ready to hand the rhythm section award out after he heard Jake play just like the first four bars of our whole set, and it was just so good and laid down such a good feel. So way to go, Jake, appreciate having you in the live stream.
Yeah, Jake!
Woo! It does feature Jake on bass too. So all right, this is called Certified by Steve Williams. Thank you again so much for turning out. Really appreciate all of your efforts and support and everything in the entire program, every student in grade 6, 12, et cetera, et cetera. Thank you very much. Drive home safely tonight. Thank you again, everybody. It's so great. Yes, I do consider myself to be very lucky to work with these brilliant young minds and players. So thank you, parents, for all of your work raising them, encouraging them, and all those other things that happen at home to make them such incredible human beings. They truly are a delight, a blessing.
I'll take it.
It's just incredible. It's only one job that I would get up so early for and be here by 6:30, and that's to work with these guys. So thank you very, very much. Drive safely tonight. If you're out and about this weekend, we do have our Jazz Festival going on all day on Saturday, so come check it out. There are 25 different schools and 40 bands from around the state here on the high school campus. So